Well, as cities across the country push to become the home of the new Amazon headquarters, Governor Dayton's taking heat from some who think he's not trying hard enough to woo the company.
And at the same time, drawing fire from those who say it is wrong to court that retail giant while ignoring homegrown small businesses. John Croman joins us with the latest. John?
Well, as you mentioned, dozens of states and cities are competing for Amazon's second headquarters. $3.7 billion project, the promise of 40 to 50,000 new jobs. Governor Dayton says we're making our best effort, but not giving away the store.
Minnesota's top selling point is Minnesota, as far as Governor Dayton's team is concerned.
The qualities that we think that they say themselves they're looking for, that we think we have at a very high level and in abundance.
While New Jersey's Chris Christie has made a high-profile play for Amazon, Minnesota's taking a more buttoned-down tact.
A business-like proposal without the gimmicks and the gadgetry and all the sensational PR stuff.
Now, Amazon's search for a second home has sparked a nationwide bidding war, but people who gathered at a bookstore in South Minneapolis called on leaders to make a similar play for small businesses.
It's a lot harder to do what they should be doing, which is say, every day, small businesses are creating jobs in our communities. What do they need?
Danny Schwartzman owns Common Roots Cafe and is part of the Main Street Alliance.
It's about access to affordable health care. It's about support for child care, so it's easier for our employees and our customers to go to work and make ends meet.
The owner of Mischief Toys in St. Paul also questioned the government's priorities.
While Amazon and other huge companies like it have received literally hundreds of millions of dollars in tax subsidies, small business owners like us wake up every morning wondering if we're going to have health insurance again in a few months.
I would agree with them.
Governor Dayton says the small businesses make a good point, but he doesn't see a conflict between competing for Amazon and creating a better climate for local businesses.
It's not either or.
Now, Minnesota's offer didn't include a dollar amount. In fact, at this stage, Amazon's only asking for an inventory of what incentives might be available. Right now, if you threw in all the money in all of Minnesota's incentive programs, it would add up to about $36 million. That's for everybody to share statewide. So even if we become a semifinalist, it would take action from the legislature to up the ante. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, John.